Hey y'all, it's Staff. I hope that you all are having a fabulous Saturday. So here is my video that I was talking about to answer the question, do I smoke weed? The answer is no, I don't. And I wish that I had asked if you thought I did, because it's so funny. So many people, I don't know why, I guess it's just the way I am. Or the way I act, think that I'm always high. Or maybe, I don't know, whatever. Anyway, teach their own for whatever reason that they're judging me, thinking that I do. Maybe they're just, oh, what's going on here? Just asking, you know, because so many people in recovery do. So I have some things to talk about with that, and I had to write them all down because I wanted this to be organized and not rushed and leave anything out. So real quick, I think this needs to be the theme song for this video. Let me see if I can hear it. Let's see. Been so long. So, it has been, I don't know how long. 260 something days, I don't know, a little over 9 months. So with that said, today I am 100% alcohol and drug free. Since the last time that I had something to drink was on July the 28th. That's when I went out with a blackout bang to detox. Yeah, the 28th of 2018. So, yeah, I never imagined going 28 minutes, much less since July the 28th. Nothing but a miracle. If you don't believe that it's possible, I'm proof. I promise. I'm not kidding. So, okay, let's see. Why? Because it's illegal. Why? We would, as alcoholics, we don't do stuff that's not legal. No, seriously. I am terrified. I'm like just really terrified of what it would lead to, because I know me and my addictive personality. And they say, let me see, it's 9%. The NIDA states that 9% will become addictive. And my ass would fall in to that 9%. And that smoking pot could possibly lead to drinking again because it lowers your threshold for relapse. And all of that came from the National Institute on Drug Abuse, which is the NIDA. And it just scares me because I'm afraid that if I started having too much fun, then I just don't know what would happen. And reading that about like your threshold and all that going down and whatever for the alcohol, it's just not somewhere that I am willing to go. I'm not going to take that chance. So, I'm just terrified. And I hate the smell. Like like in high school, I guess I liked it. Obviously I did. But over the years I would, but it was totally never my drug of choice. Like that was nothing that, I wanted alcohol. And it was just something that was extra, you know, but I really don't like the smell of it, but I love to eat edibles, or I did. I don't anymore, but I did. I would eat them like the freaking Cookie Monster and the gummies. Oh my God. Oh, I love those things. Loved them. But the thing is, I wouldn't use them. Well, I would use them to get high. Don't get me wrong. But I would, I love to eat them and go to sleep. I mean, that is the main, like 75% of the time, that's why I would eat them. Because I have had insomnia for so, so many years. Like since my daughter is 22 now, she was like 1.5. And in one of my videos, I stated that that's when or maybe it was in a meeting, I don't know. That is when I started drinking, was when she was a baby and my husband was traveling. And, like, I would have, like, a glass of Behringer White Zinfandel. I was such a wine drinker. Oh my God, I would throw up even if I smelled that shit today. But that's what it started out with. But like over the last few years, I would eat them in order to sleep. Or when we would take road trips, because I'm like a little kid in the car and I don't like really stop. I go 90 to nothing, and it's kind of like giving a dog a Benadryl on a trip in the car. That's, I would eat edibles and just kind of like chill out and mellow out. So those were really the main times that I would. Or if I didn't have any wine, which was like very, very rare that I had no alcohol in my system, much less in my house. Yeah, that probably never really happened much now that I think about it. Or maybe if I needed to go buy wine, I would like have some on my way. I don't know. That's so bad. God, it's horrible. The things that we do, it's just, thank God we don't have to live that way today. I'm so grateful. Okay. So I love to eat them. And like if I smoked them, if I ate them now, do I think I would become a pothead? I don't think I would, because I don't enjoy it that much. However, anything's possible with me. I wouldn't put it past me. And I'm just afraid. Yeah, so. And I have read and heard so many of the medical benefits of it for anxiety. Just whatever. The list goes on and on. And sleep. People that have been, that are in recovery, that it helps them. And, I get it. Like, good for you if you can do it. I do it right now to go to sleep. I have been up since about 3:45 this morning, and I don't even know what time it is. I don't know. It's like 4 or something like that. And like, I'm so tired, but like, I won't go to sleep. But I would, if I didn't have anywhere to go tonight, I would totally eat some and go to sleep. But again, I am not, I'm just not going to go there because I'm just so afraid. I just don't know. I'm afraid that I'd let my guard down and I just, you know, I don't want to go there. So, yeah. And you know what? I don't feel the need to change the way I feel today. I'm happy. I feel great. Well, I mood wise, I'm great. Like my body's falling apart, but, you know, I don't need to get out of my head. And so many times to get out of my head, I wanted to get out of my head because I was such an alcoholic that I would drink not to think about the person that I had become. And there's a great part in the big book that talks about that. And I don't have my big book up here, and I'm not climbing those stairs again to get back up to this room. But that's what it talks about. And that is exactly how I was. But I don't have to live like that today. And I don't feel that way today. And I don't feel that I need to change the way I feel. Now, if you tell me that it would help with I do have anxiety. And I never had it until I went into treatment. But if you told me it would help with my arthritis that I developed when I got out of treatment, I wouldn't want to do it, but Lord have mercy. Maybe if it was medically prescribed, I would, but I totally get people that do it for whatever reason. And I am not judging anybody, like anybody at all, because I mean, who the hell am I to judge anybody? You do what works for you. You work your program and I'm working mine. In changing my mental state goes against the honest program that I'm trying to work for myself, which is my program, not your program. That is just how I am trying to live today. This is what's working for me today. I can't tell you what tomorrow is going to bring. I pray that with each and every day, I'm stronger and stronger. And I don't have to go back to anything like that. But if I do, then so, you know, I've tried. Nobody knows what tomorrow brings. That's not my intentions by any means. But again, I am around it. I have a lot of friends that do it. People in recovery, people in my home group. There are people everywhere. And whatever, if it works for them, if it keeps them from drinking, you know, And that was never my drug of choice. And I have, a lot of people are like, well, I had this written down because I knew I would forget it. Let me find it. Because this is really good. And I don't want to forget to say this. Oh, here it is. People say that you're sober if you smoke pot, obviously. Some say you're not. I say, it's none of my damn business. You know, do what you want to do. Do what you got to do to stay sober. But work your own program. Here's what I was looking for. Some say that sobriety applies to your drug of choice. That wasn't my drug of choice. So, I could say I'm sober and smoke. I'm choosing not to. So, that makes a lot of sense. I would like to apply it to myself as being sober with zero mind-altering substances in my body. But that's me. That's my truth. You work your program and whatever works best for you. But, you know, if at the end of the day, if that's what helps you, I'm the last person that would ever judge anybody. I promise you that. You know, and today I choose to be free from any and all mind-altering substances. I don't even like to take my trazodone anymore because the way I would start to feel when it would start to make me sleepy, which I guess I've never been a person that would even get tired, but I'm like, well, hell, maybe this is what you're supposed to feel like when it's time to go to sleep. But I don't even like that feeling. And I don't like pills. So I would have been the last person that I say that, because I could be wrong, but I probably would have put a needle in my arm before I would have been a pill head, because I cannot stand to take pills. But I finally gotten off of it. I'm almost 4 weeks, I think, out off of it. And I've started to take something else, but it's just something over the counter. And I've taken it like 3 or 4 times, and it kind of works, and it's some generic crap from Walmart, but at least it's not prescribed. But I would like to get to where I don't have to take it. And I took it last night, but I went to bed really early. That's why I've been up since 3:45. Excuse me, anyway. I'm sorry. That Topo Chico, it kills my chest. All right. I think that is all that I have got to say on that. I just want to work an honest program to myself, you know. I have to be honest. And today, this is what, you know, works for me. I can't say that, you know, in a few weeks down the road, I might get cataracts and need some weed. But that's not today. There was one other thing I wanted to say, and that's why I wrote it down, and now I can find it. But, you know, whatever. So, I guess at the end of the day, you know, you just need to fully embrace to thine own self be true, you know. Whatever is your truth, and that's what, you know, you got to live with. Whatever you can sleep at night with, if it's working for you, then that's great. You know, I just don't want anything to cause, like, any euphoric effects. I think I might be crazy enough. I don't need anything else in my head. I can't remember anything, so I have to write everything down, and then I still can't remember it. And I don't know, I've always had a bad memory, and I guess all this alcohol abuse is definitely not helping it at all. But whatever. Anyway, like I said, you know, I don't judge anybody. Oh yeah, I know. I'm around it. Like, my son lives in Colorado. I've been to Colorado twice where it's legal, you know, and it's not the thing about it being illegal, because obviously if we want it, we're going to get it. And most of my friends are in Alabama and Texas where it is not legal. But I go to Colorado, and I'll be there, you know, I'm there a couple times a year, and I'll be going back soon. I'm not sure when, because when I talked to my son 2 days ago, it was freaking snowing. So, and like 31 degrees. So I am, not a fan of the cold at all, but you know, I can be around it. And that to me, I think proves how bad I want this. Because I just don't want to go back to where I was on July the 28th. From what I remember it wasn't good. I don't want to relive that. And God willing, and me trying my very best each and every day. I will never relive that day again. I will, in my mind, unfortunately, what I remember, I will, but I just hope I'm never faced with that day again. So anyway, y'all, I've got to get running. I am actually going to, I don't know where that came from, actually going to a speaker meeting tonight. So if you guys haven't ever been, I encourage you to go. They are super awesome. It's where someone will get up, if you're not familiar, and they will tell their story. And it's really cool. It's one of my friends telling hers tonight at my home group, and we're going to go eat Mexican and no margaritas, which is fun. Sure is a lot cheaper bill too. And no headaches tomorrow. But yeah, she was one of the first people, ladies, that I met at the very first meeting that I went to. And this shows how shallow I was. Oh my God, I'm so embarrassed, but I'm so real. I tell the truth. I don't lie. I tell it like it is, in a nice way. Actually, I don't even tell it like it is, but I tell the truth. So, you know, you gotta look for the similarities. And so I'm sitting there like, I don't have anything in common with these people. I'm not an alcoholic, even though I left and went straight to the liquor store, but whatever. So I see this pretty blonde come in, and so you're looking for the similarities, not the differences. And I'm like, I just don't fit in here. You know, I'm not one of these people. I am not one of these people. Then I started hearing stories and I'm like, oh shit. I did that, I did this, I did that, and this. And then I see this blonde walk by and she's got on her Rolex and her Louis Vuitton. And I was like, ooh, there's some similarities. That is shallow. That was me. That is not me today. I do not give a shit about any of that at all. I like my stuff, yes, but it does not define me at all. At all. You know, I never wear my watch. I have it on right now, but either I have on my Apple Watch or I don't even wear one. And I only wear my Apple Watch mainly to the meeting so that when my text goes off, you know, I can make sure it's not one of my kids or my husband. But half the time, I don't even, like I said, if I'm not going there, I don't even have on a watch. But whatever. Hey, whatever gets you to the meeting. I mean, she definitely caught my eye, but her story is what caught my heart. So don't be shallow like Daphne was. Yeah, anyway, I hope you guys have a blessed night. And I think we need to like launch a boat to get me out of here because it has not stopped raining all day long if you're out in Texas. I hope everybody stays safe and you guys have a great sober Saturday night.